Today we have come to this really nice space in East London to have a Hack Day workshop where we're teaming up four artists and musicians with four technologists from R&D, and we've tasked everybody with finding something interesting to do with smart speakers, things like Amazon Alexa, Google Home, that kind of explores their sonic and interaction possibilities as an instrument or as a interactive sound device of some sort.
It's my first time working with something like this. The idea I had was to be able to do a kind of duo with an Alexa and to have some sounds coming from the device and some sounds coming from me.
This is Spencer from BBC Blue Room. He is trying to make me musical, the poor, deluded fool.
Well, I came in with some preconceptions and they have been smashed to pieces. Well, I didn't realise there's certain limits about Alexa in that it'll only play 5 audio files per interaction with a maximum of 90 seconds. At the minute I'm going using SSML and basically use the device as a voice sort of synth kind of thing. Getting it to sort of speak in tongues a bit, I suppose.
We're sort of trying to interfere with Alexa, try and get her to have a conversation with herself.
Today I'm trying to build a voice-activated looper, a drum sequencer, so that you can go and say, Alexa, add a drum track that goes 1-1-2-2-1-1-2.
Here goes.
So right now we're trawling through APIs, trying to look at exactly what parts of the components of similar systems, similar forms of algorithmic surveillance and text analysis can we as practitioners pull at and expose in order to get a bit of a closer view on the way these technologies are actually functioning.
Well, what we've figured out is how to get the Alexa to hear a sample of a voice. And through that, we're making some music using samples.
The collaboration in particular is really, really important. Like being exposed to people who work in a different way to you and have different ideas about what they want to achieve is really, 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 really important.
With a musician, it's like, well, actually, it's a speaker and you can hack it. Does it actually have to sit on a desk? There's lots of, it makes you think about it as a different device and different potential for interacting with.
So we've got another 45 minutes of getting stuff ready, then we're going to have a little break and we're going to do a little kind of relaxed performance of everything we've come up with, but hopefully we'll get to see some interesting stuff.
Echo, tell the audience we're ready.
We're ready. Graham, bring in the hi-hats. A song. I'd love to. Welcome to MC Lexi. I say boom and you say bap.
Bap. Boom.
So our intention here was to expose some of that stuff that's happening in that pause between you talking to the device and the device talking to you.
Alexa, are you capable of love?
Wow, yeah.
There are people I admire and things I can't do without, but I'm still trying to figure out human love.
The tube's made of sunshine.
Telly, Messiah. Telly, illogical.
Wounded Rossism, cosmology, and politics.
Stop.
Funky, yeah.
I think we've learned loads about different ways of approaching this type of work that even if it's not necessarily for musical things, there's tons we can learn for everything else we do with these devices.
Well, I think like anything with piece of technology, the limitations can be strengths, and it's trying to find that sort of sweet spot, really.
To get going, it really took quite a while, and then some of the technical limitations also, they're forcing you to be a little more creative.
What I didn't really appreciate properly until I started doing such collaborations with them is that their remit towards the public really changes what their view is on like what a good product is or what a good output for all these kind of things are, because they really have a a real social engagement with what they do.
So out of today, we're going to take the work that everyone's been working on. We're going to use it to lead the creative conversation around what the kinds of things should we be doing with voice.